Go back to that penalty kill, partner, right? Hawks got a big lift off of that. Next thing you know, you got a 1-0 lead.
And now it's tied. Draisaitl, the Hawks unable to control it behind the net. The Oilers go cross-crease. Draisaitl with a tap in, and we're tied.
Face-off win for the Hawks. But the turnover, the quick play to the front of the net, Ennis, Yamamoto. And Draisaitl's on the other side.
No, Leon Dry. Now a Hawk turnover, Draisaitl shoots one. Good block by the man who turned it over. And Highmore now a shot, they score. Crawford thought he had it. He fumbled it, and Draisaitl put him the back of the net. We are tied.
And he turns it over. Draisaitl with the chance. Highmore with the shot block. The shot from the point takes a crazy carom. And Draisaitl is right off to Crawford's left. Man, that was a tremendous save because that one went off the stick of Highmore and Crawford had to react. It was going to his right and then he kicked his leg back out to his left and unfortunately went right to...
With a dozen left in the period, Draisaitl settled it. He wanted Neil, then McDavid, he scores! Connor McDavid pulled it off the pad of Corey Crawford, and just as the Hawks did at the end of the first, the Oilers strike on the power play at the end of the second.
Oilers bench was yelling at Draisaitl. 15, 15, 15. Meaning that's how much time was left in the period. And the skill level of McDavid on full display here. Forehand, backhand gets stuck in and he just elevates it up and over Corey Crawford and Calvin DeHaan.
A long flip shot blocked by DeHaan, held in by Archibald, who's going to hammer it around. McDavid's on the other side. He's got it. McDavid for Archibald. He scores! Josh Archibald, after ringing around, he knew he wanted to get it to McDavid. He headed for the net. He was wide open. 1-0 Oilers.
Game four, the Oilers score early. And McDavid finds his puck. Everybody gets puck watching. Nobody sees Archibald on the other side of the ice. I mean, he is absolutely wide open. As Crawford goes left to right, Archibald goes upstairs. But a brilliant pass from a brilliant player. And the Oilers up.
Nurse for McDavid moving ahead. His shot, smother, rebound, shot just wide. Rebound, Nugent-Hopkins. He scores! Ryan Nugent-Hopkins, who started the series with two straight three-point games. He got an assist the other night. He's got a four-game point streak, and the Oilers tie. That's not going to be a power play goal.
They really didn't have anything going on. James Neal tried to bank that puck in off of Corey Crawford below the goal line, and it just laid right there. Nugent Hopkins all by himself. As you mentioned, partner, it is an even strength goal.
Hopkins had three as well, as did Leon Draisaitl, as the puck is played to McDavid down the left side. There's Duncan Keith flipping it back ahead, kicked in by Darnell. There's him, Crawford scores! Just like that! Connor McDavid of his front, 19 seconds in.
Wow. Hopkins out of the zone, a little delay to make sure that he gets the puck out. That's very important, puck management. But here, just get a puck through, it goes off the stick, follow the bouncing puck all the way to Connor McDavid, who funnels himself to the net. And right there, just a great job to be able to take that bouncing puck off the hop after he loses a check, just funnels himself over to the other side, takes a look. He wants this puck, he's wide open, you leave him that
line, bounce in, rebound, loose in front. And Koskinen made a stop, but out comes McDavid, charging down the ice. He's got a stick. He's in. Backhand. Score! A beauty! And Connor McDavid on fire early.
Scored early in this game, and watch this. Takes a look, starts to wind it up, and once he starts to get it full speed, a great job to knock this puck down en route, and he just drives it around Mata. And what an elevation of the puck in tight. So incredible to be able to make those moves in tight with speed. But he just follows the bouncing pocket at the last second, bang. It's up over top of the shoulder of Crawford under the bar, and 2-0 for the Oilers.
Spectacular stem club bomb over the line. Dreisaitl across into the slot. Out of the reach of Yamamoto. Hennis from up high. Scores! Tyler Hennis puts it through Corey Crawford. And the Oilers get their two-goal lead back.
Yamamoto with a nice job to battle for this puck in the high slot. And a little chip back to Ennis right there. One stick, a second one gets it to Ennis, and right there it goes through everybody. And Dreisaitl was a little out of the way. But maybe that distraction in front, that cross check by Connor Murphy, it goes.
Around it comes for Chiasson off the ledge. Murphy leans on him to the near side for McDavid. In for Dreisaitl, McDavid scores! Patrick Dole, his first Stanley Cup playoff hat trick. And Edmonton back on top.
But it's been a night for McDavid, and you know, a lot of pressure from him after coming in after game one, not having the energy they wanted, and he just was trying to feed this pass through to Dreisaitl, goes off the skate of Duncan Keith, and in behind this netminder, pulling to the deck to try and find a little more energy.
And with that said, he's back out with Nylander and Strome, so maybe Colton, look out, Gabe Neal with the steal, and it's a two-goal Edmonton lead.
A skilled team, so what do? Get pucks in behind, make them defend, make them bobble the puck, and right there, the forecheck is what turns this puck over. Crawford comes out to play it, and he's double-teamed by Karen right there. James Neal, the second one on the puck, takes it out from behind the net, pucks it home.
James Neal scores the goal, and Neal back on the prowl. Back in against Boquist, trying to barge through, took a whack at it, still there, scores! A follow-up up there! And it's Alex Chiasson, and it's 6-3 Edmonton.
He's for a second and absolutely buries it. But here's Neal, little chip in there, whacking and hacking, stay with the puck. And right there, Strome tries to push it into Crawford to get a freeze, but he doesn't handle it. And as a result, it goes off the pad, and right there, it comes to Chiasson. He puts it home from a sharp angle. Two quick goal by the Oilers, and they have
Calgary. It was a goal by McDavid. Butt bomb with McDavid on this near side, walks in, scores! Connor McDavid, power play goal, and the Oilers get the icebreaker.
In this game, it was hot all season long. Watch Connor McDavid here. He comes outside the zone to gain a little speed so he can attack into that slot zone. And what a shot by him. He picks the corner, doesn't try and force a pass. But because he comes up out of the neutral zone with speed, bam, under the bar, over the shoulder of the blocker side on Corey Crawford. Good puck movement.
Work gets it back in front. Huge stop. Corey Crawford. A circulus slay stop for Crawford in front. Scores. They've got it that time. Leon Dreisaitl.
Assad, who was right there on the doorstep. This is just stay with it, though, by the Oilers. And you can have the best power play in the league, but you can't have that without this type of puck retrieval. You have to find ways to get pucks back. Over to Kubalik, and he absolutely rips this one. Nice job by Doc to step in, and a winger win on that faceoff. And that's how important it can be. And that one-timer there, you talked about it, Chris. A 30-goal scorer in his first year in the National Hockey League, and that's exactly why, right?
Nugent Hopkins is in the slot, but David down low. Neal shooting, rebound loose, and somehow it stays out. Scores. Now Neal puts it in. And it's three power play goals for the Oilers on the day.
So that's a third power play goal. All the three goals by Edmonton tonight have been on the power play. And they have to continue to keep this a weapon. James Neal gets the first chance, the second, third opportunity, digging away, and then James Neal whacks it through. Just kind of pile drives it right through the pads. That puck bounced around a lot inside that paint, but right there you can see Neal with the quick hands digs in and puts it home.
19 for Neal during the regular season, hit the post on that first.
Exciting, it showed throughout this game so far. They've been the jumpier team.
Klutbom scores through all that traffic. Well, it's a two-goal game.
It's Nugent Hopkins, I believe, in front, who's looking for his first playoff goal in 9 years of hockey. This will be a confidence booster. In the high slot, you can see him get a stick on that, knocks it down, and Crawford has to deal with the traffic. I don't believe this has been done enough by Edmonton in this game. You have to get shots through the traffic into the net, make Crawford make big saves, and that one there just has eyes and gets through him. It's not a hard shot, it's just there, right there, just a perfect
make amends for last year. Lindholm had tremendous success against the Oilers, scored in each of the games. Here's Ennis across, left pop, big stop, rebound, scores! Kyler Yamamoto! And the Edmonton Oilers have scored 1:04 in.
Seidel on the entry. He wins the puck battle, a race to this puck. Get the feet moving, get to that loose puck. Looks back, that quick little play. And a nice pass by Ennis. He finds Klefbom streaking into the net. The rebound goes right to Yamamoto. Talbot does a nice job to step out and make that.
It's Lindholm. Here's McDavid shooting. Knocked down in front of the net. McDavid will feed back to Klefbom. And across. Draisaitl pulls in front. Scores. McDavid. There's the power play goal. 33 seconds in. And Edmonton leads 2-0.
Power play in the National Hockey League for this season, and no real huge shot on this play, but just good management, good pursuit right here by Chiasson to win that battle for a loose puck. Goes back to the blue line, and a little bit of a broken play here. A second opportunity for Draisaitl to bash that puck through cross seam. Talbot has to read that play and doesn't react after that puck stops, goes right to McDavid, and he chips it.
Under five to go as Benning slows things down. Nugent Hopkins puts it back in. Oh, that one. Funny bounce scores. Patrick Russell on a bouncing puck that handcuffed David Rittich. And the Oilers have a two-goal lead.
Since stepping in for Cam Talbot, hasn't been a real busy night for him. And this one here, just a follow-up by Russell. A bouncing puck that takes a left-hand turn. And that's why you aggressively pursue the puck when this puck is chipped in a little. Chip by Nugent Hopkins. It bites into the ice. The right pad of Rittich kicks it right to Russell, and he just a little chip shot over the pad to put it behind. One of those players, you know what you're going to get from him each and every shift if he's on the ice. He's going to give you an effort. He's going to play physical. He's going to step in front of pucks as well. And
here it goes. McDavid in, scores through the wickets of Rittich. Connor McDavid has his second of the night, and now it's 4-1.
This third period, I'm oppressed by the Flames, but that goal by Russell kind of loosened things up a bit, and McDavid finally punches through the neutral zone. Again, just a chip puck into the neutral zone, a bounce through, and you can watch him follow it the whole way. He's waiting for that opportunity. He senses it, pounces on the puck, holds on to it, and look at him look. He never did look at Rittich. The whole time he was looking to pass the entire